I'm going to show how I automate desktop apps in VB.NET using send keys and Win32 functions. First, I create a module called robot to execute automation. It will handle 4 automation tasks. Wait until a window is active, explicit wait, simulate keystrokes for data entry and navigation, and simulate mouse clicks. To wait until a window is active, I'll need 2 Win32 functions to get the active window title. In form 1, I'll show the active window in the status bar using a timer. Run it. It's showing my browser's active title, calendar. It also captures windows within the app. Now I add a wait for window function to check for the active window until it times out. If the window is found, return 0. If it times out, return 1. Back on form 1, I'll add code to wait 3 seconds for the calendar to be the active window. Run it. As soon as I click on the calendar to activate it, the script finds it. If I run it without the calendar being active, it will time out. Next is explicit wait, which I imported system.threading for. Now I'll create functions to simulate keyboard input. The type function will send a pass string to the active application using send keys. The replace function adds brackets around these reserved characters to prevent an exception. Import regular expressions to use this function. For keys like enter a tab, you have the defined code. For combination keys like Alt and Control, you add the character after the code. You have to set the character to lowercase for control shortcuts like copy and paste to work. Now in Form 1, I'll automate creating a new event in the calendar app. These steps wait for the calendar to be active. Uses the Control-N shortcut to open the new event window. Types the event title, date, and time. Then uses the Control-S shortcut to save the event. Run it. And you can see it created the event. I also added logical combos like select all and delete to clear a text box, or paste, which is Control V. The last thing to add is mouse clicks. You'll need this Win32 function and these constants. Create left and right click functions. I need to know the XY coordinates, so I'll display cursor position in the status bar. Run it. And you can see the XY coordinates. I'll update the script to use mouse clicks instead of keyboard shortcuts. Run it. And you can see the clicks. Now I'll demo the interface I built around the automation. Saved scripts and steps are displayed in a tree view. At the script level, loops define how many times to execute the steps. Step wait is how long to wait between the steps. If I want to use a dataset, I enter the path here. This script uses this file that has the event title, date, and time. For each step, you define the action to execute. The source for the action parameter can be the stored database value, a dataset, or current timestamp. For this step, the source is stored value, which is in the parameter field. For the steps that enter data, the source is dataset, and the column to use is defined. If the parameter is numeric, I can increment it each loop. The count can be incremented each loop as well. The loop field allows steps to be executed at different intervals. I can create new scripts from the menu. Once it's saved, I can add steps to it. To run a script, just right-click it. And that's it.